So how'd you hit him?
Not too bad, except for my driver.
Huh? Still?
Yeah. Five wood. I was hitting five wood, 210 yards. I was hitting seven wood, about 180 yards.
Yeah.
I was hitting my driver about 150 yards.
All right.
Way over the top. I can't get the driver to do the same. I can hit the seven wood and five wood exactly the same. When I get to the driver, I see this big head. I think I'm trying to hit it too.
Yeah. You got some balls. You gonna hit some?
Yeah, I got a couple of balls ready.
All right, let's go hit some. I'll video you.
Okay.
A little warm up.
Thank you.
I don't know how many balls we're gonna have.
A lot.
Hey, look at that. We won't lose many here, like in Loudon.
Okay. Yeah. This way.
Yeah. Nice.
Thank you.
What did you do, win a bunch of golf balls? Or? Every time I see
it's...
Now let it rip. Good. Now do it with good balance. Nice. So you just, that's a little timing right now.
Okay.
Just stay good balance. Once you're set up, you're good to go. Just let her rip. Nice job.
That one felt
pretty good. Yeah. Good. So you got to go through your routine, right? I can see you trying to swat a little differently now.
Yeah.
Just get your routine set up. And then you have your head, keep your head back and let it fly, right? What I'm doing here with Dan is I'm trying to get him to get a little better swing plane at the top by creating more width in his backswing and more turn in his backswing. And that's kind of what I'm kind of talking with him here with. You know, get that club wider and then let that club come in that position more behind him. Opposed to, he likes to bring it straight up and gets very steep. After doing that quick 5-minute swing plane lesson, I kind of videoed the before and after. The before is on the left, the after is on the right. And I'm going to show you a few differences here just on that little, tips. As you see at the top of the swing, the left side, you can see that handle down by his chin. On the right side, you can see the handle up by his eyes. So we're getting a lot more width. And you can see the angle of the club about 5-6 degrees flatter on the after side, on the right hand side, which is going to make a pretty big difference in how he's going to contact these longer clubs especially. And he'll come through impact. Again, his impact's pretty similar. You see in the finish, again, on the after side, that actually gets that club a lot more on plane on the finish end of it.
I was a 12 if I played once every 2 weeks. I was a 10 if I played every week. And I was single digits if I played 2 days in a row. If I'd have started 3 years ago and gotten a lesson from somebody right away to say, show me the way I should be doing it, I probably wouldn't be 3 years into this still doing this.
Yeah.
Except, Matt, now you got me to, that's where I used to be, that's where I couldn't be.
I have an idea for today. We'll give you one stroke a hole, so we'll pretend you're an 18 handicap.
Okay.
Okay, you get a stroke a hole.
Okay.
We're going to play our scramble, but I'm going to play from whatever tees you'll be playing from the whites again. I'll play from the whites. Yeah, you'll play from the reds.
Yep.
And we'll give them a shot per hole and play a match play.
Okay.
And that way we can have a little competition. Okay. You can keep your own score.
Okay.
And
I can't.
Yeah.
I'm happy faces and frowny faces.
Yeah.
Playing a scramble.
Yeah, so.
Okay.
Yeah, so we do the so it's good for her to do the scrambles. It's so more fun. But that way we can have a little yeah. game of it.
Okay.
And match play. Yeah.
Okay, yeah, match play.
You think you handle it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I just want to get off the tee.
Yeah.
So I got to get off the tee.
Nice job. Nice hit.
This shot, we got about 240 yards to the green here on this par 5 first hole. Actually got a 3-wood. I actually made it on the green in that shot. Basically today, kind of the big things that me and Teresa are working on is Teresa, I gave her a routine to work on that she's going to try to do between each shot to get comfortable with a routine, basically how to set up properly. And for me, I've been working on my transition and my downswing, so I'm just trying to bring it on the course and see how I do here. This putt's for birdie to win the hole. This is a great swing from Dan. Really nice swing plane here.
Nice hit.
I'm coming back. That was so good. Good job.
What Teresa's doing here is kind of getting to that routine. I have her extending her arm straight out, kind of lowering it down to the ball. This gives her a sense of how far away she has to stand from the ball. Kind of makes it easy for her to determine that.
Nice hit.
So far, I'm off to a rocky start. I don't feel comfortable at all, and I'm kind of spraying the ball a little bit. Dan, awesome shot here.
Nice shot. Get in the hole.
Oh,
look at that shot. Yeah.
You're doing awesome,
yeah.
Dan.
Alright, give it a run. We need to chip in to have the hole.
We decided to pull the pin just because we have to chip this in to have it with Dan.
You didn't leave it short.
No, I didn't.
Nice job. Right down the middle. Nice hit. Keep rolling. That's going to roll forever. Look at that. Good hit. Ah, get out.
Nice job, Dan. You got out of there.
Nice contact.
And Dan for a putt for par here.
That was a really good putt.
And he'll go ahead and make this in the hole with a 5. So this is a birdie putt for us to win the hole. So here the wheels start coming off me a little bit, as this is just a very poor shot for me. I'm just feeling so uncomfortable with the swing. It's most likely due to the fact that I've been practicing and working on my transition, my lower body and my upper body kind of working separately, and I think that's affected my timing. Seeing our beach video, we did a lot of work in the sand. With Teresa and that little line behind the sand was kind of drill we did, and this is her best shot ever. out of the sand that she's hit. And yes, it is against the rules to draw a line in the sand, but we're just out here practicing and having fun. So there's nothing wrong with that. We ended up with a bogey in this hole, which gives Dan a 2-putt to win the hole and to go up one.
Nice.
This was the best drive I've ever seen from Teresa. She just really hammered this thing. Nice trajectory. Actually, a good swing there, too.
Nice job. What a rip. That's one of the best drives I've seen from you.
Thank
yeah,
you.
Good job. Nice rip. Jeez, you're hitting them good today. Look at that. You're on the green.
I
should have done the 3, you would have been right there.
Yeah.
Hit the pin. Nice putt.
Yours didn't turn at all. Oh, you just hit it too hard.
This is a clutch putt from Teresa to have the hole. Huge putt here.
Oh, nice putt.
Thank you.
Fresh. Very nice.
Thank you.
Nice hit. Nice job. Really good chip. Wow.
Aww,
that was awesome.
That was good too.
This is a par chip for Dan to win the hole.
I got it.
A really nice chip here. That's a gimme. So another half. Believe it or not, I hit this really straight, right down the middle, and I just didn't like it. My whole swing just doesn't feel right. I feel off. So even the good hits are just, I'm just not feeling it.
Oh, Dad. Oh, maybe get lucky. Yeah, it's about time you had a bad one.
I know.
Nice hit, Dan.
Good job.
Great chip here for Dan. He's been hitting a lot of good shots today, which is making it hard to compete. And I mean, even a short game, I'm not focused. That's just a bad day all the way around for me, so what kind of is that? And Tracy just lifted up a little bit out of that one.
Oh, a little harder.
That's Dan's ball right there for par, so I need to make this for par to force him to make his to win the hole.
Right.
And I do, which puts a little pressure on Dan for this putt. This is to win the hole. And we dodged a bullet. This swing right here was kind of an angry swing, as I'm getting a little frustrated with my ball striking.
It's all right. not going to roll in the right rough.
Really good.
Oh, nice contact. It's about as good as you can do right there, huh?
And Teresa hits a decent shot here. Just a little bit short of the green, but pretty good. And I'm going to go up and I'm just going to pull this about 15 yards left. And it's going to be like 30 yards long. So I hit the carve pads or something. Well, we ended up using Teresa's ball, and we're just chipping again. We're trying to chip on the green to give us a chance for par here. And putting for par here. And I'm going to go ahead and give that to him, so bogey for Dan. So we're putting for par to have the hole.
Hit the hole. Oh, same thing as me.
This drive felt great. I just absolutely hammered this one right down the middle. And I think it was right around 300 yards, and I'm not really a long hitter, so I felt really happy about that. One of the bright spots of my day.
You just pulled away. Yeah, you were all off balance. Yep. Nice hit. You rolling. Good job.
Nice shot.
Thank you.
My happiness was short-lived as I get to this shot. The timing of my body, just my lower body, really outracing my upper. And again, I just leave the ball out to the right.
You're way off with your aim.
As you watch Dan's putt here, you're going to notice he does a little kind of side swipe, almost like a figure eight type putting stroke here. Dan would definitely benefit from improving his putting stroke. So this is a par putt to have the hole. And I miss. And Teresa misses. Three putting with the Thompsons.
Aim towards the middle right there. There you go. Same thing. You just hit the toe of the club again. So you're pulling up. You're pulling away.
This shot was a low screamer that just landed in the fairway and rolled up the hill right into this position. My frustrations continue here. I mean, it's okay, it's normal to get frustrated. The important thing is that you try to keep your attitude up and positive, and try not to really let too much show out there. Don't get too emotional either way, when you hit a good shot or you hit a poor shot. This is a great birdie for Dan to win the hole.
Oh, nice putt.
And go four up.
I Nice job. Nice hit. Wow. Oh, good. That worked.
I did it.
That was really good. You're on. Oh, we're on there.
Me and Teresa ended up two putting here for bogey. And which kind of brings Dan to this putt to have the hole, which he'll just miss.
Nice job.
Dan's shot here actually ended up going into that water hazard there right in the front.
Nice job.
After me and Teresa hit these third shots into the green, Dan went ahead and conceded the hole here.
Ooh, that'll work. Slow down.
Dan has a putt for par here to win the hole. We went ahead and gave that to him for bogey, so this is our putt for par to have the hole. You can see I left a little short, so another big putt for Teresa. And nice again, putt. She comes through. Very nice putt here. I hit a nice straight drive here, but I just went right through. I just didn't know the distance. How far I was, I kind of ended up in the woods straight ahead. Dan actually hit a really good shot here. He thought it was good, but you see the marsh over to the right, and it kind of ended up landing in that.
Nice hit.
I told Teresa to aim for the cart there.
Nice hit. Four!
Four. pretty good job.
Wow. Did that go too far? Is that too long?
So I'm trying to go ahead and draw it around the trees. I just ended up pulling a little bit and ending up hitting the tree. So this is a par 5, we're on a 3 here. This is our birdie putt. And it's pretty big slope here by the hole. As you can see, that's just those balls just don't want to stop. Dan, this putt's for his par.
In the hole.
And he'll just miss that hole, and that's going to roll.
Ouch.
So for bogey, just short, he'll end up doubling that hole, and we'll end up getting our par to get within one.
Good. Too bad it's in the bunker.
two ugly shots to choose from by the green.
Slow down. Oh, that's a good try.
Oh, that was close.
And Dan ended up two putting to have the hole there. As you can tell, fatigue becoming a factor a little bit as Dan's getting a little tired. Playing hockey 2 days in a row and then out for 18 holes of golf. Well, being one down and Dan right there with a par putt, this is a pretty important trip for us. We definitely need to get up and down here. Not the greatest shots in the world, but we got a chance. This putt for Dan for par and to go two up with two to play, if he can make it. I gave it a run. And this is kind of a must-make situation. And that pretty much sums up my day. So really, again, pressure putt for Teresa, and yet again,
nice she job. Delivers.
Awesome.
Thank you.
And it turns the pressure right on Dan. This is a huge putt for him.
Oh, pressure.
The hole, which he does. Nice putt. Once again, we're chipping on the green in three here. Another missed green.
Maybe my grounders will finally work.
Yeah, maybe. What are you doing?
So after me and Teresa winning the last hole, that brings us to all square with this last 18th hole to play.
There you go. That's going in the right direction. Right over there is perfect. Head back and swing. Right? Head back and swing. Let it rip.
If you've made it this far,
nice,
watched this much of the video, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it.
Nice. Good job.
If you'd like to see more of these vlogs and videos, please subscribe if you're not already subscribed. And click the like button if you like the video. And if you notice the green way up top, is a pretty steep hill here, which everybody was getting tired of climbing. Dan's exhausted. Well, we're just trying to pop it up here on the green. We're going to end up having the final hole to finish all square. Thanks, Dan, for playing with us today.